Welcome to the Sutphen Seminar's Soul Blueprints course. I'm Dick Sutphen, and together we're going to explore the concept of destiny with talks and altered state of consciousness sessions. For most of my adult life, my primary unanswered question was, to what degree is life predestined? And after years of research, which has included writing many books, I've come to the conclusion each of us plans our life to experience with different degrees of destiny and free will. One person will structure his life to include destined opportunities and allow very little free will, while another person plans her incarnation with minimal destined events and considerable free will. Now, how this is structured seems to have a lot to do with the kind of lessons that need to be learned. In my Simon & Schuster pocketbook's titles, such as You Were Born Again to Be Together, Earthly Purpose, and Predestined Love, I explored the concept of destiny through romantic relationships. Lately, I've been researching destiny from different perspectives, and I'm more convinced than ever, at least our major relationships and the key events in all our lives are predestined. Depending upon how we've structured free will, how we respond to the people and events may or may not change the outcomes. But how we respond will show whether or not we've learned our lessons. If we respond with anger, hatred, or a lingering desire for revenge, we have not learned our lessons and will have to be tested again, later in this life or in a future life. Think of your life as a story you wrote while in spirit before incarnating upon the earth. Your soul is always pushing you to become more, to fulfill your earthly potentials. Matthew and Susan are a couple married for 14 years. They've been fighting for the last three, and they were ready to divorce when Matthew made an appointment for a past life regression. He arrived at my office clinging to a last shred of hope, feeling if he could find the true cause of his conflicts with Susan, maybe he could rise above the painful effects. During the counseling portion of our session, Matthew handed me a stack of astrology printouts. He said astrology had accurately predicted his marriage troubles. I flipped through the charts and agreed that his conflicts appeared to be destined. Then, he took another batch of printouts from his briefcase, laid them on my desk, and said, "These charts are progressions for the next 2 years. They show the conflict will continue, and if I'm reading them right, our relationship is going to get worse. Maybe we're destined to part." I told him we would talk about the future after the past life regression. And once he was in a deep, altered state of consciousness, I said, "In the memory banks of your subconscious mind, there is a memory of everything that has ever happened to you in this life and all your past lives. Every thought, word, and deed is recorded, and it's time to bring forgotten awareness to the surface so you may better understand what influences you, restricts you, or motivates you in the present." I directed Matthew back to the first time he and Susan shared a life. He began to describe an incarnation in 15th century Germany as farmers living an unfulfilling existence. He admitted being cruel to his wife. Now, the couple shared three more incarnations over the next 400 years. They took turns being the aggressor, once as brothers. The last lifetime we explored, Matthew and Susan got along more often than not, and they remained together until death. After examining the past lives, I directed Matthew up into higher self, an all-knowing level of mind, and I asked him to return to a time in spirit when he was planning his current life. I said, "Be receptive to all you perceive. On the count of three, you'll be there. One, two, three." Matthew said, "I'm sitting in a room with several other people. The room is open, arches, outdoors and indoors, meld together. The walls are a soft pink. There's a warm breeze, and we're dressed in robes. I'm sitting across a table from a mature woman. Two males are standing over there, and another is sitting beside me. I asked him what was being communicated, and he said, "I've plotted out my next incarnation, and now the elders are going over my plans." I questioned his ability to do this on his own, and he responded, saying, "Everyone does it on their own. It is complicated, but you have all the time you need to do a proper job. You better do a proper job, because you're the one who has to live it." Next, I asked Matthew, "Are you planning to get together again with a soul you currently know as Susan?" "Yes, yes," he said. "Of course, we help each other grow." The past life regressions and higher self sessions took place over 2 one-hour hypnosis sessions. Matthew was exhausted by the experience, and once awakened, he remained in the lounge chair staring at the ceiling. I told Matthew, "You and Susan are using your relationship to master a larger soul lesson, unconditional love. Acceptance of the other person without judgment, expectations, blame, or trying to control. Each incarnation, you're attracted to each other all over again, drawn together by unconscious forces to pick up where you left off. You don't remember your past lives, but intuitively, you're ready to take on the unlearned lessons. Until you've learned from your past, you're destined to repeat your mistakes." Matthew explained that during the time in Higher Self, when I directed him to silently communicate with his spirit guide, his guide explained that he and Susan had free will in regard to remaining together or divorcing. If they divorced, both would find new partners to continue learning the lessons they incarnated to master. Matthew shook his head and said, "If that's so, I can have a troubled relationship with Susan, or I can have a troubled relationship with someone else." I said, "Why not invoke the lessons you're learning with Susan and give your relationship time to heal?" No matter the outcome of their marriage, I believe Matthew and Susan will come back together in a future life. Each shared incarnation results in more evolution and deeper love. Love is the most powerful force in the universe, and whatever fear shuts out, love will eventually let in. Often, as part of a past life regression, I will direct my subject back to a time in spirit when they were planning their current life. Between lifetimes, we rest, work, study, and prepare to reincarnate. Usually, master teachers, highly evolved souls, will gather with an entity to plot needed lessons for the next incarnation. This includes the entity's involvement with hundreds of other souls and all the karmic interactions to generate learning opportunities. Astrology, the exact moment and place of birth, sets the soul on a path that will serve as the basic blueprint for the earth life. This pre-birth planning session is part of the cycle of rebirth for every individual. The masters do not tell you what you are to encounter in the new life. They suggest, but you always have the free will to override the suggestions. And based upon years of research, it seems to me that most people tend to be very brave in spirit. They believe they've learned their lessons from the mistakes of the prior lifetimes and are anxious to take on the mantle of a human body to balance their karma and to test themselves once again. All right. It's now time to begin your regression preparation. So in just a few moments, I'll be directing an altered state process that takes you back to a time in spirit when you were planning your current incarnation. But first, let me share some important information.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.